आप कल सुनते थे कि वो क्षेत्रज्ञ ज्ञाता है, आप उपदेश कर रहे हैं, समझो समझो ऐसा बोल रहे हैं, श्री मैं ही क्षेत्रज्ञ हूँ, मेरे संसार है, मैं ही संसारी हूँ, ईश्वर कैसा हो सकता हो, ऐसा प्रश्न समझ आ रहे हैं। प्रश्न क्षेत्रज्ञ बोलते हैं कौन है, ज्ञाता है, आप उपदेश कर रहे हैं, इसका मतलब क्या है, मैं नहीं जानता हूँ, हाँ समझा रहे हैं मुझे, मतलब मैं नहीं जानता हूँ, आप ही बोल रहे हैं ना, है ना, इसलिए वो मेरे में अविद्या है, मैं संसारी हूँ, मेरा स्वभाव है, इसलिए ईश्वर कैसा हो सकता है, स्पष्ट हो गया ना। चेता नहीं सुनो, कहाँ है, नहीं समझ रहा है तुम ऐसा बोलते ही, क्या समझना, समझ सकता है ना, समझ सकता है लेकिन नहीं समझा है, इसका मतलब क्या है, अविद्या है। अब ये प्रश्न अविद्या कहाँ है बोलना पड़ेगा, वो भी नहीं है, अविद्या क्षेत्र में नहीं है ऐसा दिखाना पड़ेगा। सर क्या बोल रहे हैं, सुनो, अविद्या मतलब तामस प्रत्यय है, मैंने सब प्रकाश से दृष्टांत लेके शुरू करते हैं, तामस प्रत्यय, तामस मतलब यहाँ पर मेरा आँख ठीक होने पर भी मैं नहीं देख सका, तो इसका मतलब क्या है, प्रकाश नहीं है इसे मैं देख सकता हूँ, है ना, इसलिए तामस प्रत्यय, मैं नहीं जानता हूँ, इसलिए क्या करना पड़ेगा, लाइट आकर, लाइट लेकर आगे आना पड़ेगा, और देखा नो आई एम अंडरस्टैंडिंग, यू विल से हैव यू फॉलोड नाउ, ओके, देयरफॉर व्हेन यू से अविद्या, अविद्या इज ओनली तामस प्रत्यय, आई डोंट नो, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू नो यू हैव डाउट, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू हैव रॉन्ग नॉलेज ऑल्सो, देयरफॉर एसेंशियली इट इज ओनली तामस प्रत्यय, सो यू पुट द ब्लेम ऑन light to start with, outside it, no, oh, but I am not understanding, even when there is light I am not understanding, then I can have a fault in my eyes, is it not so, similarly I have, no, no, see, the fault in the eye, if you say, if you you have to saturate the eyes, is it or is it not? You are yourself telling the fault is in the eye. Therefore, eye has to be saturated. Not the kshetrajna. Kshetrajna is different for even from the eye. Are you following me? Therefore, that is only a karana dharma. Karana means what? Instrument. So it's a karana dharma. Okay. Then he says, oh, in that case, you see, there are only people who are not at all interested in Shastra. Okay. And there are jnanis. Okay. Therefore, who has to listen to this Shastra? Shastra and Arthakya. No, no. If you say that there is no avidya at all, you say that there is no avidya at all, then it means that Shastra is useless. Shastra is there only to enlighten you. But there is nothing to enlighten. There is avidya is not at all there, you are telling. And Shastra means, no, no. During avidya, you have to know. During avidya, you have to know. That is, you see, he is not making absolutely clear. Bhashyakara is not making absolutely clear because he is growing step by step. That's why I told you, if I, in the beginning itself, if I told the, tell it, then it will be very easy to understand. But afterwards, if somebody asks the question, you will get confused. Therefore, gradually it is being prepared. Then you will know, oh, these are all the arguments. Now, it becomes clear to you. Like that. Therefore, during avidya, you have to know only. And the avidya is only karana dharma. It is not in kshetrajna. That's it. So, then he says, see, he is telling, he is making the statement. What is the result of avidya? Bandha. Bondage. Is it not so? No. As far as dvaitis are concerned, bandha is a real thing. Moksha is a real thing. That is, bandha exists. Now he is telling, avidya exists. As a result of avidya, there is bandha which exists. Okay? Therefore, they can remove it. For you, there is no avidya. And for you, there is no bandha, is also simply imagined. You have simply imagined that there is your bandha. You are telling Kshetrajna by himself is already very pure. There is nothing to correct him. There is nothing to teach him. He is already great. Only you have to know, actually. I am myself Kshetrajna. You are not Kshetrajna, you are somebody else. Because you are always seeing in the mind, you are always seeing, sitting in the eyes, you are always sitting in the mind and thinking. Did you follow? See, I am persisting throughout that there is mistake in me. There is mistake in me. I am having bandha. When he is making this statement, when he is, where is he sitting? Have you understood? Now, therefore, Bhashyakara is gradually dragging that person fully out of like this and put him outside all the karanas. Because he is Kshetrajna. Are you following or not? Did you follow? He is always sitting here. Therefore, someone has to be pulled out with great effort. Now see yourself, he wants to show. Therefore, he said, now he is asking the question, there is bandha. Bandha is real. Therefore, avidya is there. Bandha is in me. I know it. See, I am crying. Is this question clear? Then he says, ननु आत्मनो बंधमुक्तावस्थे परमार्थदे वस्तुभूते मते द्वैतिनां सर्वेषां अतः हेयोपादे तत्साधनसद्भावे शास्त्राद्यर्थवत्त्वं स्यात् अद्वैतिनां पुनः द्वैतस्य अपरमार्थत्वात् अविद्याकृतत्वात् बंधावस्थायाश्च आत्मनो अपरमार्थत्वे निरुषेयत्वात् शास्त्राद्यानर्थक्यमिति चेत् See the meaning? Dvaitis say that bandha is there. Advaitis say there is nothing like bandha. You are already all right. What is it? I am not all right. How should I? You certify or I should certify? I am myself certify. I am in bandha. I am crying. I know. I don't know. He said, I know, I don't know, if you say. To know that you don't know, you must be knowing. Yesterday we have discussed this. Therefore, people are always, whenever it comes to reference I, there is always a blunder, a hopeless blunder. Here, however much you may say, you will always stay in the mind. You will always stay in the Indriya and then talk. Okay? Therefore, the Dvaiti is asking, Bandha is real, Avidya is real, but for you it is aparamartha, it is actually not there, it is only imagined. Because Bandha is real, Shastra, he takes the help of Shastra and gets rid of Bandha. Okay, for you it is imaginary. Therefore, Shastra does not do anything. Only he has to correct his imagination, that is all. Shastra has no use. Now, see, follow carefully now. All of us feel that Bandha is very real. I am struggling like hell. I am not being able to get rid of it. Is it or is it not? Mm-hmm. Now see this argument. Now what he is showing? He is showing that Bandha is not real. Even Mukti is not real. Mukti is only description. That is all. Nothing. He is telling. How? See. Iti chet? Na. Atmanah avastha bhedavatva anupatte. Iti tavat atmanah bandha mukta avasthe. Yugvat syadam karmenava. For kshetrajna, that is atma, there is nothing like stages. Avastha. One state, another state. Are you following now? Are you following? For kshetrajna, there are no states. Now see carefully. Are I am having states? Which are the states? For instance, I am Bhush Prajna, Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti. There are three avasthas are there. Okay. Jagrat is an avastha. It is your experience. Very good. Take it. Swapna is an avastha. It is a status. You know it. Take it. They are there. Okay. Now, how are you telling that Sushupti is an avastha? Follow my question carefully. You are telling Sushupti is an avastha, it's a state. How do you say? You have come out of it. Is it not so? I have come out of it. Who has come out? Who has come out of it? See, for instance, I was Bahish Prajna. When I went there, I was not Bahish Prajna. Therefore, I came out and became Bahish Prajna. Okay. Similarly, I was not even Bahish Prajna, Anta Prajna, in Sushupti. Okay. So, I came out and became Anta Prajna. Are you following? Therefore, I am experiencing at this stage I was knowing, then I am not knowing. Then I am not knowing. Okay. But in the case of Sushupti, how are you telling that you have got up from there? How do you say that that is an avastha? Are you following the question? How is Sushupti? You are telling that it is a status. You say, I was sleeping. I was in Sushupti. Okay. You know you were in Sushupti. You are telling. Okay. What is Sushupti? Not knowing anything. Not knowing anything is Sushupti. Okay. So that was the state. Now I am knowing. Okay. But this is Kshetrajna. Kshetrajna is not the one who is knowing. The one who is knowing, He is now knowing, he is not knowing. States will be there. Are you following? See, for knowing, not knowing, they are the states. Okay. But at that stage, there is nothing like not knowing also. Where you throw out, say for instance, no, you know, I am not getting sleep. I am not an antapragna. Because I am disconnected. I have that experience. That experience is there. No, I am not knowing. But what is the difference between antapragna, bhishpragna and kshetragna? Antapragna and bhishpragna are in the act of knowing. He is not in the act of knowing. Is it clear? No, he is not in the act of knowing. Okay. He is correct. Then who is he? Tell it positively. He is not in the act, he is not in the action of knowing. Where is he? He is knower. In Sushupti, what is he? He is only knower. There is no action in him. Okay. So the knower is knowing, as knower he is knowing, that Sushupti is also coming and going. He is a knower. Therefore, the Sushuptatma in Sushupti is knowing that Sushupti is coming and going. The Sushupti Sushuptatma is knowing that, oh, dreams are coming and going. Same Sushuptatma is telling, oh, this wakeful state is coming and going. He is the knower, is it not so? Did you follow?
Yes.
No, I did not follow. Once again, see. Sushuptatma is the knower. What is he knowing? He is knowing Jagrat is coming and going. Sapna is coming and going. Sushupti is coming and going. He is always knowing, or is it not? And he is doing only that. He is doing only that. What does it mean? It means he is not actually knowing something else. He is only knowing the states are coming and going. He is knowing that. Okay. He is not knowing the door. He is not knowing the wall.
He is the knower who knows that these states are coming and going.
Ah.
Knowing word means knower. He is the knower.
Yes.
Knowing is a
verb. It is only knower. There is no knowing activity. He is
a knower.
In other words, you use another word. He is only the witness for it.
Yes.
He is only the witness for all the states coming and going. But he is not actually knowing. Why? Because he is not connected to the mind. If he has to know the something else, he is to be connected to the mind. Therefore, Kshetrajna is one who is not connected with the mind. He is only the knower. Therefore, he is always awake. Even in Sushupti he is awake, in Swapna he is awake, and in also in wakeful state he is awake. Therefore, there is no change in his state. There is no change in his state. Change is there only in Bhishmaraka and Antapragna. Has it become clear? Therefore, he is always only the witness. There are no states. Have you understood? So, look at this sentence. Atmanaha avasthabhedavattva anupapattehe. Don't associate him with the change of states. Has it become clear? Now next thing. Now, yadi tavat atmanah bandhamukta avasthe. Now I have told in very general. Now you take another type of avastha. I mean having bandha avastha, mukta avastha. Okay. Bandha avastha, if you say, now, what the Bhashyakara is showing, bandhavastha, muktavastha are not real. They are imaginary. He is showing. How is he showing? Yes. Tell me. Bandhavastha, muktavastha, bandha and mukti, are they existing together? Or are they coming one after another? Now he is proving. What is he going to prove? He is going to prove that both are imaginary. No? The yugapat syatam karmenava. They should come either together or one after another. Suppose you say they are together. Absolutely nonsense. Bandha, mukti, dono, it's there, simultaneous. Is opposite to each other. Therefore, they cannot be coming together. I follow? Why they are opposite? Sthitigati eva ekasmin. He is also stationary, he is also moving, you can't say. It's opposite to each other. Karma bhavitve. Next, take this picture. Karma bhavitve, there is a karma. It comes one after another. Karma bhavitve cha nirnimittam samitittam va sanimittatvam va. They are coming one after another. Theek hai? Are they coming with some reason or without some reason? Bandha is coming, are they coming with reason or without reason? The question. Suppose you say with reason, then you will saturate the reason. Okay. Suppose you say without reason, then you will say without reason if it is coming, it means it is very natural. Follow carefully. First see. Bandha, mukti, are they coming together? No. So rule out. Now, bandhavastha is coming, then muktavastha. Or muktavastha is coming. You have to fix the sequence. Okay. Now say, you have accepted coming. They come. Are they coming with some reason or without some reason? They are coming because there is some reason. Okay. One reason, I did not know, therefore it is coming. Suppose you say, this is the reason, I did not know. So it is, it came. It has come. When it comes, it has a time origin. And if it is because of avidya, okay, does avidya come? Does not knowing come? See, I don't know. Is it coming from somewhere? Have you not understood?
Yes.
Does it come at some point of time? I don't know. Does it come? Therefore, what he wants to show is, that is, if I don't know, I simply don't know, that is all. Is it not so? You take an example. Do you know the capital of Chile? Don't know. Since when you don't know? The question is meaningless. I don't know. That is all. Since infinite past, I did not know. Okay. Have you understood now?
Yes.
No, he wants to prove it. I have told you the answer. He wants to prove that it is only due to avidya. Okay. So now, is it coming because of a reason or without reason? Suppose it is coming with some reason, say something like avidya, you will set it right. Suppose it is coming without reason. Suppose bandha is coming without reason. Then it means Bandha is your natural state. If it is your natural state, you can never remove it.
जैसे आपने कहा कि ये बंद अगर नेचुरल होता है तो इसको हटाया नहीं जा सकता, तो ऐसा कोई आप उदाहरण दे सकते हैं कि भाई कोई नेचुरल चीज ऐसी जो हमारा बदल ना पाए?
नो, फॉर इंस्टेंस आई एम इन बंधा, इट हैज नॉट कम, आई एम इन बंधा ऑलवेज. We all feel like that, is it not so? I am in Bandha since infinite past. Don't we say that? We say it or not?
Yes.
Suppose naturally it is there in me. Suppose you say that. Then you can never get rid of it. Bandha is my natural state. Your Shastra, whether it exists or it does not exist, doesn't matter. 1,000 gurus may come and tell you it won't go. Because it is our natural state. Did you follow or not? Suppose it is my own nature to be in Bandha, it can never be got rid of. Followed? Therefore, if it is nirnimittam, that is without any reason, then we can never get rid of it. If it is nimittam, then you get rid of the nimitta. That is all. For whatever the reason. The reason for this reason it has come. And you know that reason. You remove it. It will go. As far as Kshetranya is concerned, it is aloof. Did you follow now? As far as Kshetranya is concerned, it is aloof. Because of this reason it has come. He removes the reason and that will go. So removing the reason, Shastra is there. It will help you. Don't say it is coming without reason. Have you understood now? Oh. Nirnimittatve adhirmoksha prasangaha. Without any reason, then you can never get moksha. Sanimittetveja svataha abhavat अपरमार्थत्व प्रसंगः तथा सति अभ्युपगमहानिः सर्वतत्व. इफ इट इज विथ रीजन देन बंध इज नॉट नेचुरल. ओके, यू हैव टू गेट रिड ऑफ इट. देयरफॉर यू टोल्ड, ओ इट इज नेचुरल, यू टोल्ड इट इज नॉट नेचुरल, नाउ यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट यूर सेल्फ. इट्स नॉट नेचुरल, बंधा इज नॉट नेचुरल.
स्वामी द्वैतियों ने कब कहा कि बंधा नेचुरल है? उन्होंने क्या कहा एक्चुअली? द्वैतियों ने कहा
नो सनिमित्तत्वेच इफ इट इज विथ रीजन देन व्हाट हैपन स्वतः अभावात अपरमार्थत्व प्रसंगः.
अच्छा ठीक है, पर वो
इट इज नॉट देयर.
अच्छा, वो बंध मुक्त को परमात्मा मानते हैं द्वैती?
यू आर व्हाट आर आस्किंग नो
द्वैती बंध को
परमार्थ. Paramartha means actually existing.
Achcha. Theek.
Is it clear? Aparamartha to prasanga. Tata sadhya abhyabhagamani. If it is really existing, if you say, then you can't get rid of it. Okay. Now leave all this. Take another. See, all sorts of arguments you will bring and simply destroy it. Now, next question, Ingincha, something more. Bandhamuktavasthyoho purvapari nirupanayam bandhavastha apuram prakalpya anadmati antvati cha. Tacha pravana virutta. Okay. Bandhamuktavastha, I have to come up one after another. Okay. Now, Amma?
Muktavastha?
We don't know. I define it like this. Without bandha is called moksha. Without bandha is called moksha. Is it right? That way everybody knows. Now, the question is, bandha has to come first. only afterwards moksha. No, bandha has to come first means it was not at all, it has been existing since an infinite past. Now it has to go. What does it mean? Bandha is there. Now mukti has to come. It means only that. Bandha, since when it is there? It didn't start. Since infinite past it is there. Is it clear? Now, something which is continuing from infinite past, if it is also an existing thing, it can never be destroyed. Aparamartha means, it is paramartha means actually existing. Suppose this bandha is actually existing, and it is since infinite past, anything that is actually existing can never be destroyed. Anything that is actually existing, in reality existing, it can never be destroyed. All of you understand this statement? When a candle is burnt, nothing is lost. This is a famous statement in high schools. Is it not so? Because if you destroy the form of one form, it will appear in another form. Is it clear? Therefore, any objective thing, any existing thing, can never be destroyed. Is it clear? Therefore, if you simply say, make this hypothesis, bandha has been there since infinite past, now it has to go, and this bandha is real. If you say, your statement is absurdly wrong, because anything that is continuing since infinite past can never be destroyed.
Anything object.
Any object means any object. That's why I gave the example of candle.
Five senses. What I can perceive by
mind. Anything. No, five senses. Not only five senses, even by mind. For instance, by you don't observe time by senses, but you observe it by the mind. Is it not so? Similarly, space also, you don't see, but you know. Mind. Let it be anything. Now it cannot be destroyed. That is, any object which is existing can never be destroyed. It's a contradiction in terms. Have understood? Therefore, if you say bandha is a real thing and is also existing since infinite past, then it is a contradiction instead. Therefore, that is also not correct. So, how? Bandhamukta Puryavindrupana Bandhavastha Puram Anadimati Antavati Cha. It is there since Anadi time, and it will end. No, it cannot happen. Nothing that is really existing can never be destroyed. Tacha pramana viruddham. It is not logical. No pramana is there to certify this statement. What is the statement? It is existing since infinite past. No, it is destroyed. You have no example at all for that. There is no pramana. Tathacha. Mokshavastha adimati anantacha. Pramana viruddham. Applied to moksha. Moksha has no, it didn't exist at all. Now afterwards I will get real moksha. Are anything that is not at all existing, how can it start? How can it be created? Have followed? therefore nacha avasthavatah avasthantaram gachatah nityatvam upapadayitam shakyam. Anything which is anavastha, you say, it can never be nitya. Avastha means itself means comes and goes. So anything that comes and goes is not really existing. It is only in your imagination. Are you following or not? See, we are talking real means. Form is not real. Form is not real. I am seeing it. But we are seeing only the cause. For instance, you take a pot. You are seeing only the clay, but you call it as pot because of a shape. By shape itself is not an object. Did you follow? Shape itself is not an object. So it has changed the form, mean the shape will change, but it is not existing as such. It's only a word. Are all of you following? Therefore, what has happened is, atha anityatva dosha pariharaya bandha mukta avastha abhedo abhedo kalpyate na kalpyate bhedo na kalpyate. It's impossible. It's full of contradiction. Therefore, there is nothing like bandha or mukti. Okay? Atman is there. Okay? All these things are simply coming and going. All things that are coming and going, they are always only words, only forms. They are not stuff. I will explain to you. See, her question is the following. I am sure this question will be there for everybody. See, a thing is real. I am telling the part is real. Okay. When you say the part is real, understand carefully. You know that what you call as part is also there, and what you know as clay is also there. Are you following? You are seeing something as part. You are also seeing a clay. Okay. Now, between the two, which is really existing, is the question. As stuff. Okay. No, you say it is part. Okay. What you are telling as part is only the shape. And that shape is also clay. That shape is also clay. Therefore, from the point of view of clay, it is always existing. From the point of view of clay, it is always existing. From the point of view of part, it doesn't exist at all. Suppose independently you consider part without clay. Where does it exist? Without clay, is there a part? Therefore, the part is only a word. The stuff is only the clay. Are you following? Similarly here, what we call so many things, bandha, mukta, this, that, so on and so forth, they are all words, forms. Avidya, moksha. But what is the stuff which is always stays? Atman.
Yes.
No, first we call as Brahman. Call it as Brahman. Brahman is the stuff. Always exists. Don't say that these are not existing. These are existing on the basis of Brahman, not independently. Is it clear? Are you following? The part, you say part exists, certainly part is broken, it doesn't exist. But anything that exists is not destroyable. Is it not so? So what is it that is really existing? Clay. Clay is not destroyed. Therefore, it is only clay that really exists. For a certain form of clay, you give the name as part, that's all. The form by itself has no sense, it doesn't exist at all. Is it clear now? Similarly here. Now look at Pratyagatma. Pratyagatma is always there. He's not created. He's not coming, going. He's not changing states. In childhood, in youth, in old age, everywhere for anybody, at any time, the same. Therefore, Atman is the real thing. That is Kshetrajna. Whereas, Bandha, Mukti, Avidya, this, Jnata, Kartrutva, all things are simply related to telling something else, that's all. They are only forms. I followed now. Therefore, Bandha Mukta Avastha Bheda is not there if you say, then it is simply imagination. Shastra Andarthakya. Certainly Shastra Andarthakya is there. Shastra Andarthakya means what? What does Shastra do? But it exists only in the say, at the time during avidya. As long as they don't know this, it's only Atman that is existing, nothing else. I am always there. I am neither in Bandha nor Mukti. I am always Mukta only. But till I don't know this, Shastra is helpful. मार्गदर्शन के लिए है राइट एंड व्हाट डज इट शो मार्गदर्शन व्हाट डज इट डू अल्टीमेटली मीन्स यू हैव ऑलवेज बीन मुक्ता ओनली यू हैड नेवर बीन एट एनी टाइम इन बंधा यू आर ऑलवेज आनंद स्वरूप ओनली यू आर ऑलवेज ओनली वन देर इज नो वेराइटी इन यू. There is no multiplicity in you. This shows. Is it clear? So, see, as reflect on it for 1 minute. Bandha Mukta Avastha is real. It exists. He claims. Now, Bhashyakar wants to prove they are not real, they don't exist. He wants to prove that. How does he prove? Are Bandha Mukta Avastha coming together or one after another? It's coming together is illogical. One after another. No, ask. Is it coming for some because of some reason or without reason? If it is without reason, then you can never get rid of Bandha. With the reason, we get rid of the reason. It has nothing to do with, the reason has nothing to do with Atman. Okay. Then, you say, Bandha Mukta Avastha are there. Are they coming one after another or not? Yes. So, what do you think of? Bandha is there, then Mukti comes. Yeah. Now, you say, Bandha is real. Since the infinite past, I have been in Bandha. If you say, then it can never be destroyed. Similarly, to say there is nothing, moksha, suddenly it came into existence. It will exist forever, if you say. That is also a wrong statement. Have you understood? Therefore, bandha mukta avastha is coming for a reason. What is it? Avidya. Avidya is there, avidya is not there. Therefore, shastra anarthakya is not there. Till avidya is there, we will use the shastra. Nasha shastra anarthakyam yatha prasiddha avidvat purusha vishetva shastrasya avidyam hi phalahetvoho anatmano atmadarshan navidusham. See, you have been seeing so much. One disconnectivity somewhere. Are, there is a jump I am not getting. Clearly it goes. There is not even Shastra Andartakya now. For you there will be Shastra Andartakya. Because you are insisting it is real and all that. If it is real, what can Shastra do? Shastra Andartakya is for you. Not for us. In avidya time, okay, it is helpful. Because,
na? Shastra, ladies par sakti
hai. Huh?
Shastra, ladies par sakti
hai. Ladies. Are you not lady now? You are listening to me. No, I will tell you. Tell the brother. This is knowledge. Jnana. Now for jnana, everybody has a right. Everybody. No difference at all. But in the case of karma, there are rules and regulations. Karma means activity, so on and so forth. Therefore, there are rules. I mean, just because you have asked the question, 1 minute I will deal with it. Now, all karma that is told for Purusha is not told for Stri. Okay, every day he has to do that karma. Some karma or the other is there. Nitya karma, every day you have to do sandhya, etc. is there. Can the woman do? She got period. She becomes pregnant and all that. And postnatal period and all that. Okay? Therefore, she cannot do. Therefore, Shastra knows this. It makes a division as far as karma is concerned. But in the case of knowledge, everybody has a full 100% right. Is it clear? So, always respect the Shastra. Shastra doesn't commit mistakes. We, in our arrogance, we commit mistakes. Okay?
Yeah. We were talking about bandha and moksha, that they are actually not there. Bandha is not actually there. But we also say that ignorance is beginningless.
Ignorance?
Ignorance anadi hoti hai. Avidya anadi
hai.
So, who kis context mein
hai? Now, look at this question. See, you told avidya is anadi and is also goi. For half an hour, you explained that anything that is real will never go. Okay. But now you are telling avidya has been there since infinite past, now it will go. If I make this statement, it is wrong. If you make it, it is right, is it? No. See, remember this word. What is it? Aparamartha, paramartha. Anything which is really existing can never be destroyed. Is it not so? Now, avidya is not a thing that is existing. It's a very relevant question. Avidya is not something which is really existing like an object. Yes. For instance, it means this. Oh, see, avidya means I don't know, I know in a confused way, or I know wrong way. This is avidya. But for confusion and also wrong way, the base is only this. Okay, not knowing. Therefore, not knowing is not an object. Okay. Now, I know it wrongly. This knowledge is existing, but knowledge will be corrected after education. I also want to caution you one thing. Since a long time, people have been telling that avidya is a stuff which is actually existing. People have been, in fact, they are married to the statement in a very firm way, Agni Sakshi. They don't want to divorce. Okay. No, it's absurdly wrong. Wrong to the hilt. Okay. And that it is wrong, Shankaracharya himself has told in several places. And in Sambandhavartika, Mandan Mishra Sureshwaracharya has told it emphatically. Emphatically he has told. Okay. Some other pandits have concocted and other people have hugged it. Okay. Therefore, the statement of Shankaracharya, he says, is, because you asked this, it's a very relevant question. I am giving a quick answer. Says, just now, nothing that is existing can be destroyed. You have heard this statement? In other words, anything that is existing, it will change its form. It is not destroyed. Okay. What is destroyed is the form, not the stuff. Therefore, if candle is lost, I cannot talk it as candle. I can talk it as smoke, ash, smell, light, etc. That is, it becomes anvaya in another place. It was applying as candle here. Now it applies as smoke, light, etc. here. It's called anvaya. It applies in another place. Upakhya means you can explain it in a different way, in another form. Anything that is existing, there is no loss of it at all. It can be explained it stays in another form and it can be explained in that way. It is anvaya upakhya. Have you understood?
Form means akriti.
Form means only shape. Form only by itself. By itself it doesn't exist at all. It exists with a certain thing. Because it exists with certain thing, that is not lost. So that will show itself in different ways. So it becomes anvaya in some another form. And also you can describe it in another form. Clear? So Shankaracharya, all of you tell this statement. Nahi bhavanam niranvayo nirupakhyo vinashaha sambhavati. That is, for existing things, niranvaya, nirupakhya, vinasha does not take place. What is niranvaya and nirupakhya? It can be done anvaya in another form. It can be described in a different way. That is upakhya. There is no another form. There is no, you can't describe it at all. Such a loss will never happen. Niranvayo nirupakhyo vinasha na sambhavati bhavanam. Okay? Remembering the words? Now listen to this sentence. Shankaracharya says, I will tell you. Brahma vidyaya avidyayascha niranvayato nashitatvat kuto vishesha samjna sambhavah
kuto vishesha sangya sambhavah.
This main sentence is this. Oh, by Brahma Jnana, okay, avidya is lost niranvayato nashitatvat. Tracelessly it has been destroyed. Now I was told, anything that is existing is cannot be destroyed tracelessly. He has told this. Now he is telling it is stresslessly destroyed, he has told. Are all of you following? See, just don't be timid. Oh, he has told, no. If you study Vedanta like this, you will never understand. Let anybody tell, I have to understand. When she, see, even if Shruti tells, I have to understand. If Shruti is not explaining properly, then I will ask somebody, please tell me what it means. So my understanding is final. When I understand, I can't be timid. Are all of you following me? You must be bold. You must not be a coward. Therefore, in Sambandha Vartika, Sureshwaracharya tells clearly, this avidya, you can never even define it. It is only simply a word. It was neither existing, nor is existing now, nor will it exist in the future. These are the words he has told. Okay? In fact, all opponents of Advaita, they take this issue as a big issue. You are telling avidya is bhava? They are fighting. But Shankaracharya has told it is not bhava, it is, he has told it is abhava. He has himself told it. Have all of you understood? I'll stop here. Bola. Shruti Smriti
Puranam. Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashyakrito Vande Bhagavantau Punapunah Ishvaro Gurvatpeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyakta Devaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah.